guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be going through my favorite foundations just in time for the Sephora sale. So the Sephora sale is this Friday, starting with the Rouge with 20% off, and all the other dates will follow with 15% off and then 10% off. So I will leave the dates down below for you to reference. I actually got a few questions regarding my favorite foundations, especially after I bought that whole Tarte haul. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I was promoting it because I was telling you guys that there was 30% off Tarte.com, which is in Canada the only place you can buy the Shape Tape foundation and the Shape Tape concealer, which are two very, very popular products. So you can't buy them on Sephora, unfortunately, but that kind of led to this whole conversation about my favorite foundations. So I just thought I would do a holistic video in case you guys are looking for a new foundation. I have all the foundations here. Out of all the foundations I'm going to be going through today, only two of them you will not be able to buy from Sephora, but everything else you can get from Sephora. And don't worry, I will tell you which ones those are. The other thing I wanted to mention is that these are my top picks for foundation. I feel like I always have to say that in case someone out there is like, oh my god, well, this foundation is blah blah blah, and it's like, yes, I know there's probably a million foundations out there, I haven't tried them all, but these are my personal favorites and I think you guys will really like them too. I thought about how to do this video, and I think the best way for me to run through this video with you is to categorize these foundations. So the way I've done it is I've done two more unique ones, which I'll start first, then I'm gonna go with more of the sheer ones, then some of the more well-rounded ones, and then lastly I'm gonna end up with two heavier coverage foundations, and then overall I will make a recommendation at the end so you guys know what my picks are. So starting with the two unique foundations that I have for you, the first one is Charlotte Tilbury's Hollywood Flawless Filter. If this is not your first time watching my video, you probably have already heard me mention this product. This one has actually appeared in one of my monthly favorites. So personally, I have actually used this as a foundation, but I actually discovered that her purpose of making this product is actually, number one, as a primer. Number two, you can put it on top of makeup. The applicator is super cute. I actually like this because I can use it directly on my face. It is actually also meant to just be put on the high points, and you can use this as a highlighter. The reason why I've added this into this video is because even though she might not have necessarily meant for this product to be used completely as foundation, I actually found that it was light and also heavy enough for a very light and natural foundation. And what I like about it is after I discovered how she uses the product, this is quite versatile and you can actually use it in so many different ways. If you see me glancing down at my phone, it's because I also wanted to pull up the prices for you so I can say it. All of the prices that I do mention are in Canadian, but I will find the American prices later. It's just so hard when you're not in the States, you can't really find the American prices, so I'll try to write it down, but at least you'll get a good sense of which one is more expensive and which one is less expensive. So this one sells at $53 for 30 milliliters. I personally like this if you are looking for a primer or if you want just really, really light foundation, like a CC cream, BB cream type of thing. I would personally take a look at this one and try this one out. Once again, I just really love the applicator. It makes it just so much easier and you don't have to dirty your hands or put too much product on your sponges or your brushes. So this one is good for that. Last but not least, I wanted to mention that for the Hollywood Flawless Filter, I am in the color 3. The second item that I want to mention is the Guerlain L'Essentiel foundation. So this is what the package looks like, and as you can see, it is so cute. The reason why I wanted to bring this one on, and it is part of a unique product in my eyes, is because number one, the foundation itself is actually thicker than most other foundations that I've come across. The consistency is definitely more dense, and the reason why is because this foundation is actually a really good combination of skincare and makeup. So I personally use this when in the mornings I don't have time for my skincare routine. I will try to use this foundation. There's a lot of natural properties in this one. There's also some sort of chemicals to kind of like deflect blue light. I know there's an article talking about like how blue light is a scam, but anyway, I don't know. I'm one of those people that believe in these things. So the other thing I really like about this, which is going back to the whole when I'm lazy and I don't put on my skincare in the morning, is that this also has SPF in it already. If you're also Canadian, it is actually really hard for a product to be labeled with SPF in Canada. If you go buy the product, it is not advertised on Sephora. It is also not advertised on the bottle. If you can see from the bottle, it's actually blocked out. The components are in there by every other country's standards. So just wanted to put that out there because this is a really good product when you're lazy and you just want to throw it on without having to put on any other skincare because it already has a lot of the properties. For this foundation, I actually can't really tell you exactly what color I am just because the bottle that I have is a little bit lighter. Right now, I have to kind of like mix it in with like some darker shades in order to kind of get my match. So I don't use it as much anymore. I just like try to wait until I'm pale or if I have time to be mixing the colors. So I'm not going to tell you my foundation color since it's not very accurate, but I can tell you the price, which is $67 for 30 milliliters. And so just to kind of give you a benchmark, this was 30 milliliters, this is also 30 milliliters, and this one is 67. Now that I'm done with my two unique products, I'm gonna go on with talking about my favorite sheer foundations. These are the foundations that I find have light coverage, but enough if you have a good skin day, so like no pimples, no nothing. If you don't really have too much bumpiness, I feel like this is really good. Or if you're starting up makeup for the first time, I also feel like this category is also really great for people who are just starting out makeup. This category is also, I find, very popular with the parents. You'll see later, my mom stole one of my products in here. This is also the category that I started off when I started using makeup before I started to search for other things. So I'm gonna just get started with it right from the very first product that I wanna show you, and you guys are gonna die because this is literally all I have. This is the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation. And guys, I kid you not, I have purchased this product, I think 10 times since I started wearing foundation. This is the first foundation I have ever had my hands on, and I still love it to this day. I actually gave the last bottle to my mom because when I went back to Vancouver, she liked it. So I was like, hey, fine, you can have it and I'll buy it another time. So far, I have this little sample size. This can keep me going until I need to buy, or I guess until Friday. I really recommend this product. It is super natural and it doesn't have a very heavy coverage. It honestly goes on almost like water or like it's already skin on your face. I highly recommend trying this out. So the color that I use is Fiji. This bottle sells for $61 at 30 milliliters. So far we've only seen 30 milliliters. The one little thing that I do not like about this foundation is the packaging. So obviously this is not accurate packaging, but I will show you a picture. It is basically like this, and you have to twist the cap off and you just have to pour the foundation, which I hate. But I found the foundation pump on Sephora. Honestly, I think this is new because when I first started wearing foundation, this was definitely not on Sephora. But they're selling it for $8, which first of all is like, are you trying to rob me? Like $8 for a pump? Why did this bottle not already come with a pump? I don't understand. This is like, honestly, like I don't understand why there wasn't already a pump to begin with and then a cap to cover the pump. Like every other normal foundation, like this one. Okay, anyway. End of mini rant. That is the only thing I don't like about this foundation. Just to mention, if you have this foundation or if you're planning on buying this foundation, it is in your best interest to twist that cap tightly, my friend, because like I said, I have used this foundation for years and years, and I have traveled all throughout Europe with this foundation on my tiny little backpack, and it went all over the place. So take it from me, and please shut your lids tightly. This is why they need to convert to pump. Okay, so the next foundation is one that you cannot find from Sephora. It is the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Fresh Wear Foundation. Wow, that was a mouthful. This is what the bottle looks like, and this is by L'Oreal, so you can get this at your local drugstore. This I was sent to try, and I ended up loving it so much. I finished the entire bottle. I actually shared it on my Instagram. They sent me 3 bottles because they weren't sure what my color was, and unfortunately, I didn't take a picture of what color I was either, so now I regret my life. The reason why I love this one so much is because, in my opinion, I feel like this is a really, really good dupe to the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation, and I just searched up how much this product is, and it is only $19.99. Is that a lie? Like, I'm not sure. But anyway, $19.99 for 30 milliliters. This foundation is just so comparable to the NARS Sheer Glow that I highly recommend. So the next and last foundation in this category is the Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. So if you watched my February favorites video, you would have already heard me talk about this. This is what the bottle looks like, but I have the travel size version. And once again, the reason why I have the travel size version is because of two reasons. Number one, I was only trying the foundation because there was so much hype about this foundation. So many people love it that I was like, okay, I want to try it, but in case I don't like it, I didn't want to buy the entire bottle. It's also not a cheap foundation. So I bought this instead. And the second reason is because this is such a great bottle for travel. So I figure after I finish using it, then I can refill it with something else. And this is just so much littler and it's so cute. But anyway, this foundation at full price is $80 for 30 milliliters. So I think so far we have only seen 30 milliliters. And I don't know if I forgot to mention, but the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation, the full size, not this little sample size thing, the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation was also 30 milliliters. So once again, we've only seen 30 milliliters and you can already see the difference in price, but the Armani Luminous Silk Foundation is $80. $80. Oh my God. That is literally like four of these. Okay, so anyway, my review for this foundation is that it is honestly amazing. I find that it is a little bit thicker than the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation in terms of coverage. Also applies like water. So it's really nice because it has this like very natural look while having the coverage that you want. I don't know. In my opinion, the other two foundations are comparable enough that you don't need to necessarily spend another $20 on this foundation. But honestly, that's just my opinion. If you're hesitant, I recommend either ordering both to try. I think they're doing free returns right now, or when you get a chance and when the stores open back up again, just grab two samples of each foundation and give it a try. But I don't know, just out of price, I would just say, I don't know, try the L'Oreal, try the NARS, and maybe give that a try a little bit later when you're feeling bougie. But I did want to mention for this foundation, I'm in color 3.5. Moving on to the next category, I feel like this video is gonna be so long and I hope that some of you actually stay till the end because it takes me a long time to film and edit, okay? So the next category, I only have two products for you and this is my most well-rounded category, meaning it is not too light, but not too heavy. And I think this is a foundation that is very good for people who have used makeup for a couple of years now. They want something a little bit heavier, or you know, you are someone that just needs heavier coverage to begin with. Maybe there's like a lot of things you want to cover up and like BB cream, CC cream, sheer foundations are just not doing it for you. I feel like this is a really good everyday foundation for this, or actually, sorry, two, because I have two foundations. Anyway, the first one I wanted to talk about is the Dior Backstage Foundation. So this is what this looks like. It is in a very cute bottle and it's also very light, so very compact. I was actually very shocked because when I took a look at this foundation, this is 50 milliliters, so almost double of what we've seen so far. And this is only $50. So literally a dollar per milliliter. And this is, I think, the cheapest we've seen. And I'm actually very surprised coming from Dior. Is this website lying to me? Okay, this is straight from the Sephora app. The reason why I like this foundation is because it is a little bit thicker. It's also very long wear. And just now looking at the price, I'm just like, okay, why do I not buy more of this foundation? Such great bang for your buck. Also, the applicator. Okay guys, I was shaking it, okay? So that doesn't count, but I was gonna say I really like this applicator as well because it doesn't make a mess, except just now, obviously, when I'm about to show you about how it doesn't make a mess, it makes a mess. You know how things always do that. Obviously, I don't like that, you know, you have to put it on your hand, but whatever, it's still better than some of the other applicators we've seen, NARS Sheer Glow. Anyway, yeah, I really recommend this foundation now more than ever, now seeing the price compared to how many milliliters. Sometimes the price just doesn't do it. You have to look at how many milliliters you're getting. So the second one that I also highly recommend is the Charlotte Tilbury Light Wonder Foundation. And this is $53 for 40 milliliters. So it is a little bit more expensive than this one and you get a little bit less. So overall more expensive. However, I do really, really love this foundation. I personally kind of like it more than the Dior, but now looking at the price, I don't know, I'm just kind of sold. Other than the price, I actually really love this foundation. Just to give you a sense of how much I like it, I wore it for a wedding last year as a bridesmaid and it just stayed on all day. It was great. It just has this like really beautiful, dewy, but like enough coverage type of finish. And it's just very buildable, and also all the other products you put on it afterwards make it look really good. I don't know, I personally still really recommend this foundation, and the color that I am for this foundation is a 3. This one is once again at $53. And sorry, I forgot to mention, but the Dior foundation, I am in the color 1W. So that was pretty much the end of the well-rounded category. So now moving on to heavy coverage. So once again, I only have 2 foundations here for you. The first one is one that you cannot find on Sephora, and this is a recent favorite. This is the Tarte Face Tape Foundation. This is what it looks like. It literally looks like the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, but in a larger bottle. So what I really love about this foundation is I feel like it really truly lives up to its name. It is pretty much the consistency of the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, but not as thick, but it has the same idea. I also recently bought 2 brushes to go with my face tape family. So this is the concealer and what that looks like, and this is the brush that I bought. And this is the foundation, and this is the brush that I bought. The reason why I'm mentioning this is because this brush has allowed me to use a fraction of the product I would have used if I used like a beauty blender, and it applies so nicely. The dual together, it allows me to use a lot less products by just changing up my brushes. If you're unsatisfied with your current foundation, but you know that it's either like a really good foundation, or you know that other people really like it, just first maybe check your applicator. Is your sponge good? Are you using your brush right, etc.? Is your brush clean? Have you washed your brush? Also look at the products you're using afterwards, like your compact powder or your translucent powder. These are some of the things that you can look into first before completely ditching your foundation. Anyway, this was a really nice discovery for me. I feel like in the long run, this will pay off given how much foundation I'm gonna save by using this. I'm gonna see if it's in the Sephora website. If not, I will leave a link down below for all the Tarte goodies, because you can't buy these from the store anyway. Back to this foundation, once again, much, much higher coverage than any of the foundations I've talked about so far. Overall, very smooth, really like it. It's the foundation that I have on today, actually, so if you're interested. The color that I have for this is 22 neutral, and it's light neutral. So the last foundation I want to talk about is the Airbrush Flawless Foundation by Charlotte Tilbury. First of all, the packaging is just so glam. So if you're really into packaging, this one is definitely gonna get to you. The other reason that I really like this foundation is because it applies, I don't know what it is, I personally really like it. It also just goes on so smoothly. This is the foundation that I got the most compliments on whenever I wear it. People were like, why does your skin look like porcelain or something? I've literally heard this twice, and it's always because I was wearing this foundation. And the reason why I don't wear this every day is because on a daily basis, I tend to go for the more sheer stuff or for the more well-rounded stuff. And then these 2 foundations I use more for date nights or like events or going out or something. You know what I mean? You just gotta give the people something else on special occasions. If you wear this every day, then, I mean, not saying you can't, but I'm saying like, if you wear this every day, then when it's your wedding, it's gonna be like, oh, she looks the same. Now that I have given you, oh wait, sorry, I need to give you the prices for that. What am I doing? The Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Foundation is $53 for 30 milliliters, and this one is $51 for also 30 milliliters. I feel like 30 milliliters is generally the status quo here, so I feel like it's a pretty good benchmark. This is the unique one that is a whooping 50 milliliters at $50. So that's pretty much my entirety of my review for my foundations. Now getting to the recommendations. My recommendation is I feel like you should always have 2 foundations. The reason is because, like I said, one for everyday use is good enough, and then the second one is for special occasions, or like if you're not having the greatest skin day, you just don't want to have just one option. Even the reverse, like let's just say you're having a really good skin day, you don't want to look like you're kicking your face. It's just nice to have like a sheer foundation. So overall, the first product I'm going to split into 2, because one, if you have like like pretty good skin already, slash if you're leaning more towards the natural side, I feel like this one would be the winner just in terms of price. And it's similar enough to the other ones that you don't necessarily need to buy the other two. If you prefer a little bit higher coverage for every day, definitely the Dior. It's such long lasting and hello, the price is amazing. So definitely the Dior. And lastly, for the heavy makeup, I'm gonna have to go with this one, the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Foundation. Honestly, it really lives up to its name. The reason why I choose this one over the Shape Tape is because of the application. It's really heavy coverage, but it doesn't feel heavy. It still feels quite light, and also the compliments, you know, although I haven't even gone out with this foundation at all. So regardless, I would definitely recommend this one for your heavier coverage. So anyway, that was pretty much the video for today. I am so sorry that this video is so long. If you've made it this far, congratulations and thank you so much. If you have any recommendations for me to try that isn't here in my collection, please let me know and I would love to try it out. I love trying out foundations. Or if you have any other questions about the foundations, don't be afraid to leave a comment, because I tend to respond on here a lot faster for some reason. Once again, I hope you guys are doing well and staying safe and also staying home. And I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!